Oh, yes.
When are we moving in?
We'll take it. If you could have this house for nothing, but you had to live in it with me, would you?
Don't know. Who would kill who first? That'd be the question, wouldn't it?
James, how you doing?
Very well.
Nice to meet you. Drew?
Come in, please.
Hi, how are you doing? Nice you all right?
Well, yep. Thank you for having us. Please. Marvellous. Oh, my. James, amazing.
Thank you very much.
Amazing. So tell me about the place, then.
We've been here for roughly 1,000 years. still in the same spot.
So you farm here, then, still?
It is a farming estate. There are 19 tenant farmers and 25 cottages which we let out.
I'm hoping for some really good finds, because will I ever get the opportunity to go through a house like this again in this condition? I don't think so. I'm sort of a bit gobsmacked, really.
Trying to work out where you're going to start.
I don't know where to start.
There's so many places.
I don't know where to start. There's so much in here. I mean, it's just mind-blowing. Look at that. Wow. It's like a time capsule.
Nothing's really been altered at all.
But nothing in the main body of the buildings for sale? These
no.
are all. That's all
no.
out of the way?
Out okay. of the way.
I'm a bit gobsmacked. Can we have a look around?
Yes.
Do you mind?
Welcome. No.
Which way first?
Shall we go show you
sure.
through to the saloon?
This is the most quintessentially English country house interior I have ever seen, bar none. Everything about it is just screaming total authenticity. Age, patina, colour, it just goes on and on and on. If you've got millions and millions of pounds and you employ the best interior designers in the world, they can just about get close to this, but never as authentic as this.
The pieces in this part of the house might not be for sale, but even the chance to appreciate them is a rare treat for Drew.
Oh, my God, look at this. Oh, look at that table. You've got that en suite as well, the console suite. Is there another one of those?
There's another one up.
You've got two of those. That'd be about right. Oh, yeah. Look at that. Oh, my life.
This is a pretty thing. I've got the bowl to go on this. It's a Christopher dresser. He's up the top there. It's his Egyptian pattern bowl.
Really?
Yes.
Wow. Dresser's one of the giants for me, in my head.
Really?
Yeah.
This is probably not him. They put it on a classical base.
Yeah.
Right. But for Victorian hallways, you know?
Yeah, because I always steer clear of them. Because,
yeah,
you know,
they're not popular
of...
now, I don't think. But the urn, you can see, it's got the reeds. I've just done a little repair on it.
So we're wandering around and I see this very garish pedestal. Really not my sort of thing. This is horrible. And then Alan goes, oh, that's Christopher Dresser. And I'm looking at it going, it's not. And they said, no, there's a pot on top that's designed by Christopher Dresser. Immediately, my interest is piqued. One of my all-time favourite designers, right up there. Genius. That's that dresser bowl.
That's right.
What, the two repairs? You've just done two very small, aren't they?
I've just done it with a bit of enamel paint. That's all I've done.
Are they chips?
Yeah, just the surface glaze came off.
I think what's easier, rather than moving that, the other bit's lighter, could you get
the
pedestal?
Yeah, I'll go get
the pedestal for me, please. It's beautiful.
Pretty, isn't it? Yeah. You like the glaze?
Love it.
British Racing Green with a bit of yellow, hey?
Love it. Beautiful. Gorgeous thing. What a lovely thing. What Dresser did was come up with something totally new. It's never been done since. Nobody's ever got it that right. No, I'm all right.
Yeah.
Yeah, it sort of works.
Strange, isn't it? Yeah.
When he started out in the trade, Drew spent years working markets like this and still has a soft spot for them today.
There's nothing more fun than wandering around an antique fair. Bacon sarnie, have a coffee, do a good bit of buying. I love this stuff. Look at that.
He's beautiful.
Isn't it great?
He's terrific.
Yeah. How much is he?
He's 90.
He's lovely.
Everybody does exactly what you've
do that.
Just done.
Yeah.
He's so tactile. It's
he used
amazing.
To be that high.
That's it, that's it. Yeah, he's worn him down over time.
There's this thing I kept looking at and kept touching, this beautiful buffalo or bison, and it's just great looking, and I can't take my hands off it. So if I can't, somebody else is going to feel the same, aren't they? And it's 90 quid. I think I can get 180. I think I can double up.
This modernist-looking bull was made by Ruschka, a German company that was a prolific maker of lava glaze pottery in the 1960s and 70s. The finish gets its name because the texture and appearance mimics that of volcanic lava as it cools. West German pottery like this is becoming increasingly popular. It could be worth around £200.
I've got to have him.
You got to have him?
I've got to have him, yeah, thank you very much.
OK, I'll take your money.
I can't not have him.
This I like.
Yeah. It's junk, but look at that big names carved all over it.
Ex-Winchester College boarding house.
Got to have it.
Loads of fun. Multiple carved names.
It's covered in names and vandalism, old period names scribed into the top of it. It's charming. And then T says, actually, look, it's from Winchester College. It's from the boarding houses. Great.
This pine chest of drawers dates to 1860, when it was supplied to Moorshead Boarding House at Winchester College. The names and dates carved by former pupils, known as Old Wickhamists, add to its character, and it could be worth around £580.
A split second, I saw it, so I'm having that. Really unusual. It just, you know, takes you back to some kid there, probably by candlelight, you know, scratching his name into the top of it.
Start me at 150. 150. 150 I have, straight in, thank you. Is there 160? At £150, any more? £150 last time.
It's excellent. Bit of luck, finally. Just go straight in, just people off. Get in.
It just really speaks to you as such a lovely history, great condition, really usable, and wasn't a lot of money.
670, 700.
He's got two great pieces in the bag, but when it comes to bidding, Drew's remaining disciplined.
150 on the net, 160.
He's sticking to the game plan and waiting for the quality lots that most appeal to him.
Oh, look at that. Lovely.
I'm having this.
There is a large leather-painted room screen, profusely painted and very colourful. A decent-sized house, though, well, right, and cover a whole wall, and it's great fun.
This six-fold room screen is Italian and features hand-painted country scenes on a leather background. It probably dates back to the 19th century and could be worth around £1,500.
What I liked about it, running all the way through the middle, there was, like, hens and birds and animals and people all over it. Really nice scenes. Great size, really tall.
There we are, magnificent thing.
Come on, I want this.
I'm going to start the bidding here at 320.
Let's go straight. 340,
did I say it now?
Let's go straight. 304.